My main mission in life is to enrich lives. Amplifies who we are. My friends, this is a really exciting webinar and presentation. I'm really thrilled about it. This is something that I was afraid of for a long time for some reason. I'm not exactly sure why. Probably just organizations and paperwork and everything that is required to build something great can be terrifying and scary, but I have an amazing team and a phenomenal group of people that helped me put this together. And I want to give a shout out also to Andres Asson. We connected together at Necker Island back in December, and he also has a foundation and was talking to me because he asked me, like, hey man, what do you want to do with all of your money? It was more or less it, like, what's your goal? What are you trying to accomplish? And my main mission in life is to enrich lives. I want to pour into organizations and companies and foundations and people and charities and just a way to give hope, because money amplifies who we are on a daily basis, a weekly basis, and a yearly basis. And so if we want to become extremely giving, loving, generous versions of ourselves, we will need more money. So Real Life Foundation was created hours ago. Not really. We've been putting it together for a while, and we fully have it totally in the process of being 100% verified by the IRS and all the parties that need the association information to be passed along. But I want to share this with you because so many traders have shared hopes and interests and goals of RLT being able to donate to their charity or to their cause or to specific organizations. And I'm not ever going to say that there's one organization that's massively more important or more specific than another. But I can say this, is there's gonna be a time and a place where everyone needs a little bit of love and guidance. And from a tax standpoint, it makes sense to have one of these, you know, a nonprofit and a foundation, but it also just makes sense from a heart perspective, right? From a heart-centered, open standpoint, it's amazing to surround yourself and align yourself with people that you care about, people that you wanna spend time with, and missions and causes that just mean a lot to you. Because having this direction, having this giant dream and this huge why, allows us to get out of our comfort zone and to push a little bit more than we might. When there's times and there's days that we feel like giving up or quitting or sleeping in or whatever, having the ability and that opportunity to go, you know what? I need to do this so that we can pour more time, energy, money, and creation into a foundation so that we can take that foundation and really propel it for future generations and for future people and really impacting people directly is a big, big deal. So that's our mission, right? Our mission is to enrich lives. And we're gonna be doing that with this foundation, with this nonprofit. Very, very thrilled about the opportunity because that's our responsibility. Once you know how to make money, once you know how easy and simple it is to create financial acceleration, we now have that responsibility to provide for all of those around us. And a lot of you already do it. Most of you on this webinar already do it. And now you know that there's a backing. Now you know that this is something that I've been really, really zealously excited about for years now, and finally had the right team and the right system and the right monetary setting to do it. Because this is a place of abundance. In order to be here, in order to live in this world, you have to live in a world where you think creatively, you think big, you think excessive, you think great, you think abundant. And that's a challenging mindset for me personally to stay in it all the time. And this is an opportunity for all of us to gather together and always be in a place where we can think about that. So this is something, if you want to call it bad, right? Before any delays, we just launched a new nonprofit, Real Life Foundation. And the mission for this particular foundation is to raise money for causes that enrich lives, that really, really pour into the lives of others. And we do have a real in-person organization that we're going to be sponsoring and working with very closely at the April 2nd dinner in Miami, Florida. So for those of you who are watching this, some of you are going to be coming to Miami and some of you won't, but this will be our first official gathering for the foundation, a location and a place and a time where myself and Matt and Sochi and many of our team members get to participate in something that's really, really exciting, because unfortunately, this is an actual number that has to be written with words. 2 million kids are sold every year for sex, labor, and organs. Like, horrible, despicable, terrible. Every one of us here either has kids, we were a kid, or we know of some children that could have happened to. And it just seems to me like something that can be changed with the right mindset, some of the right beliefs, some of the right backing, with the right people. And I would love to be a part of that with each and every one of you. So what we're gonna do is in Miami on April 2nd, we're gonna have a silent auction. You can get tickets, there's gonna be food, there's gonna be the whole process, right? It's a nice little foundation. So we're raising money and raising and creating currencies for causes that enrich lives of people from all around the globe. So the cause that we are gonna be pouring a lot of time, energy, resources into right now, at least presently, this particular cause is helping Operation Underground Railroad fight the largest criminal enterprise in the world. And we all know how much damage drugs and guns, but specifically human trafficking. I was unaware of the size and the scope and the magnitude of how many people all over the world are affected by this. I've started seeing it more and more in different airports that I go in. There's like signs that say like, watch out for this. These are some warning signs. These are things to be keeping an eye on. If you see this, tell somebody, that kind of thing. And just recently, only days ago, we were in the process of building this. And then I met a gentleman who I'll share a video with in just a few moments, named Tim Pollard. And Tim was sharing the story of all the things they have to go through and all the things that they do, this company, the cause, under Operation Underground Railroad, being able to help so many, tens of thousands of children who are infants. So we're talking children. I mean, obviously the word children is very near and dear to most of our hearts, but we're talking about people, individuals that are 3 years and younger. 3 years and younger that are used sexually and abused because their families might not know of another way to create income, or they just are unaware, they're scared, or they're terrified. But this is something that needs to stop. It's something that's absolutely awful. And many of my mentors have stepped up and found some way to impact and to help and to create change. And so that's why I want to do this. So definitely a huge shout out to Sochi Rodriguez and Matt DeLong for helping me with this and helping this get created. So if you're here either live or watching this, you might want to get involved in the Real Life Foundation. And here's a way you can get involved in this particular cause, but also in future causes, because there will be things that we're going to be doing in the future. Obviously, this is something that we're going to create and build perpetually as time goes on, but we're going to create amazing gift items for auction. We're actually going to talk about those tonight. Now, this is something that we created as quickly as possible. So these gift items, we're going to go on a website that you guys can actually go on and bid on. And it's just a silent auction. I think most of you are familiar with silent auctions, where you can bid. And if you're the highest bidder, you win. And if you win and you spend the money that you spend on that item goes to the foundation or to the charity, to the nonprofit. So that's one thing that we're going to do, is we're going to create really compelling, exciting gifts for people to purchase so that those proceeds will go directly to the foundation. Obviously, you can spread the word on your social media for the fundraiser, and of course, just directly make a donation. I've had a lot of people reach out to me in the past, say, hey, Jeremy, as we go through your classes that are free, you know, this is such a great thing that you would do. I would love to be able to make a donation to whoever or wherever. So that's something that we're going to have in the future, is just a donation button. When someone goes through our free content, they want to donate $1 or $10 to the foundation, they'll know exactly that money is going to a great cause directly, right? 100% of those proceeds, those donations. So again, this is my first foundation for me personally. This is something that I'm learning a lot about. I'm spending a lot of time reading up on it and getting more involved in just the practical behind the scenes application, but it's all comes down to a team. Sochi Rodriguez and Matt Salong really allowing and helping me propel this into the future, and having such a gloriously wonderful, wonderful opportunity to get around leaders and business owners and entrepreneurs and presidents and leaders of countries, so that we can help this Operation Underground Railroad movement. So if you're coming to Miami, these are some things you can do, right? You can purchase a dinner ticket. So we're going to come, we're going to eat, right? Proceeds go to the foundation. You can buy a ticket for you or someone else. So if you're not able to come in Miami, you can still buy a ticket to someone in Miami. If you know of someone who lives in Miami, they can come to the dinner. We're going to have the silent auction both there and online. Just want you guys to be aware of this, and this is what's happening, right? Promote the event on social media, and also, you know, obviously make a donation. We're going to have a Venmo and everything set up for this. So check this out. One of my best friends, business coaches, mentors, business partners, Brittany Turner, has offered up 4 of her coaching sessions, working one-on-one with her, an hour session. So 4 hours with Brittany Turner. This is going to be one of the silent auction items. And this is an incredible, incredible value. I mean, Brittany, when I've worked with her in person, has really, really helped me think through some intentionality in both my business and my life. You all know, or most of you know, if you're watching this or you're here, that we have a podcast together called Broke to Woke. And season 2 is actually coming out in a few days. But regardless, she is a decamillionaire, right? Someone who is worth millions and millions of dollars at a very, very young age. But more importantly than that, someone who directly impacts humans in a positive way. Someone who goes out of her way to create time and energy and resources so that she can be a force for good in other human beings' lives. You're going to want an hour of her time. That is a great, great value. So that's going to be one of the silent auctions that every one of us, every single person here watching this, recorded or not, has the ability to bid on and potentially win an hour with Brittany Turner to bring your questions, your thoughts, your challenges, your hurdles, so that she can help you overcome that and have a huge, huge dream.
And by the way, Jeremy, there's actually 4 1-hour coaching sessions. So someone can buy 1 or all 4.
Love it. Love it. Awesome. That's amazing. That is amazing, amazing. Silent auction number 2, my friends, this is again a ridiculously incredible conference, Money Grows on Trees Wealth Conference in October of 2021. This is a second item, which is a $3,000 value, all inclusive resort where me and Matt and Brittany and so many other people are going to help you tactically with either your business, your trading, your real estate, your cash flow, your mind, helping you expand where you are now. Because if you think it's impossible, in fact, type in a 1 if you think it's extremely, extremely difficult or unlikely from where you are right now to double your net worth in the next year. If you think that just sounds relatively impossible. The thing is, I've done it every year for the last 2 or 3 years. 2020 was my greatest year of my life. Everyone who goes to this conference will have the ability to do it. And every single person that went to the first annual Money Grows on Trees conference 40% of those attendees have at least doubled their net worth, which is amazing. Amazing, amazing to say that. So it's because you are sitting around talking about money for 4 days, right? Talking about your beliefs, your thoughts about money, what your future vision holds for money, what your past holds about currency and wealth. Being able to sit around and talk about it. I mean, if you're being realistic, when's the last time you sat down and talked with a friend or a group of friends about nothing other than money for 4 days and got to do it on a all-inclusive resort, right? Never, exactly, never. It's something that's very rare. If you want more of something, you have to talk more about that thing, whatever that thing is. So this is an item, second item that's gonna be given away for anyone who is the winning bid. Now, someone could bid more than this, obviously. That's also very, very possible, and that would be incredible. But again, all proceeds will go to the foundation that will support Operation Underground Railroad. And silent auction number three, I'd be remiss if I wasn't in here somewhere. So I will absolutely be having a coaching session with someone as well. So that's another item that someone can bid on, right? So if you want me to work with you or your parents or your children or yourself or your family or your business, whoever, right? I got to get in on this action too. So that's going to be another auction. Another item that anyone can bid on. Again, this is like a silent auction. I think all of you guys are very, very familiar with silent auction. Just wanted you guys, wanted you all to know what's happening. Number four, Matt DeLong. All right, you're gonna have some coaching sessions with your boy, Matt. Matt is one of the few people in my life who I can absolutely immediately go back in time and think of very, very specific days and hours of those days where he changed my life forever with either something that he said or just being there or the smile on his face and the motivation that he gave or the gifts of his time or his knowledge or his experience or just his love or just his friendship. Matt, one of my best friends, business partners, trading buddies, colleagues, all the things. You got to work with him. You got to. You got to. And then this one's going to be really cool. Item number five, 1 year subscription to stock trading automation. So I don't know if you guys know this, but we're actually creating and have created as a team under Real Life Trading, we've created a stock trading automated software that you have access to that literally trades for you. How cool is that? Already built, ready to go. If you have enough money, it's extremely worth it. But even if it doesn't, in general, this is a $2,400 value that you can bid on and win as an auction. Marta says, oh my God, I love it. Yeah, isn't that cool? So that'll be another silent auction. Again, another proceed that can go directly to the foundation. And then Brittany Turner has also sent out two nights for her Nashville Peace Teepee rental, which is one of the coolest Airbnbs, ready for this, in the entire Southeast. It's rented almost every single night. It has a 98% occupancy rate. So she's gonna give out two nights for the Peace Teepee as item number six. And while you're in Nashville, maybe we can all hang out together. But either way, that is also a valuable piece because just, you know, why not? It's a really, really cool thing. More, we're gonna do more. So my wife, Svetlana, is opening up her 5-week dreams course, which honestly, and she's not here to hear this right now. She's out doing some errands, but this is going through a dreams course is the one of the reasons all this came together. Right, that's one of the reasons that this foundation came together and that I'm working closely with Matt and Sochi, because I was able to open my heart up and realize that I have so many massive, massive dreams that I cannot accomplish without other people and without removing these hurdles of fear that I have. All these random fears, like I'll create this foundation and it'll take up so much of my time and energy and money and it'll just be a failure and no one will benefit from it and no good will come from it, right? Just a ridiculous, ridiculous fear. But as Marta said, no man is an island. So you have to get people around you that are amazing and that can help you and that can support you in your dreams and your vision, like all of you that are here, right? Every single one of you who are here have helped me in that in some way, in huge ways. So a shout out to each and every one of you. Dale, Ryan, thank you. Derek Washington, thank you. Edward Lynn, thank you. D. Simpson, thank you. Jason, Armenta, thank you. Jenny, Jonathan Madonna, thank you. Johnny Guarco, absolutely my man, my hero. Thank you so much. Keith Griffin, thank you. Leland Warren, thank you. Lynn Marta, thank you. Michael Pipkins, thank you. Mike Moy, Pam M, Paul C, Rhea, Robert Falco, Robin Steckel, Stephen, Thomas Wong II, Tosh, and Varian all. Thank you guys. Because this is amazing, right? Once you start breaking through these little fear barriers that we have, so many cool things open up. This is going to be an incredible, incredible opportunity for anyone to be a part of this. So again, these are all things that are going to be bid on in Miami and also online. So could you win one of these things for like a $300 bid? Yeah, absolutely. It's extremely possible. Now, is it going to go all the way up to $300,000? I have no idea. But if you want to buy tickets to the fundraiser dinner, Matt DeLong has posted a link in the chat pane. If this also is out on our YouTube channel, we'll post all these links in the description box. So if you can't come to Miami, we're going to have all of this stuff online as well. And if you are in Miami, hopefully you'll be able to participate in that as well. So what I'm going to do now really quickly is I want to just show you all a little bit more of the reason and the gentleman that I met. I want to open this up so that you can kind of watch a very, very touching, very quick. Let me actually sign in really quick. All right. Just a very fast little expose, if I'm using that term correctly, on Operation Underground Railroad. So let me post a link in the chat pane really fast so that you guys have it if you want to watch it on your own. There you go. But this is the Operation Underground Railroad. This is the movement that we're going to be helping in this particular season during this foundation.
I never dreamed that I would work in Haiti. I didn't know anything really about Haiti until I learned about a little boy who was born in Utah, US citizen, and was kidnapped in Haiti from his church, where his father was the pastor. I read about it in the local newspaper. I thought that I could make it into a US case, and I couldn't, because it wasn't. We had to leave our jobs. I had to leave my job because I just had to do something about it. We went to Haiti to look for his son.
Yeah, it's right here, right here, right here.
And we never found him.
People weren't talking about human trafficking like they are now. And really, it's because of the work and efforts by organizations like Operation Underground Railroad.
It's a subject that nobody wants to think about or talk about. It's the worst part of humanity.
Okay. Wow.
And yet, we've got to do something about it.
Please, get on the ground right now. Get on the ground. Get on the ground right now. Get on the ground. Put that down.
Every 30 seconds, a child is sold. They're sold for sex, they're sold for labor, they're sold for organ harvesting, which is something we're now getting into. There's 6 million children that are forced into one of those three categories right now, and the world doesn't know.
Not a lot of people know, but the profile for men who travel abroad to have sex with kids are American citizens.
The US creates the demand. The highest producer and consumer of child pornography is right here in the United States.
Well, if you lost one of your children to one of these evil people, you'd do anything to get even and get your child back.
I had a knock on my door one day. Tim said, listen, I really feel like I can do better leaving the government.
I'd find a group of kids in Guatemala or Colombia, and I couldn't do anything about it because it wasn't a U.S. case.
It's outside of the jurisdiction, and I understood that. However, that doesn't mean that we couldn't be doing more.
Tim Ballard left his law enforcement career, everything that he knew, his pension, his security, to start a nonprofit called Operation Underground Railroad. They've done jumps everywhere throughout the world, rescued kids, and then helped them get to a safe place with their aftercare programs.
He had a way that we could really make an impact, but they needed $1 million to start. And I said, I'm in.
We had
set up this operation that looked like it went flawless.
We unfortunately got some very frustrating news.
The traffickers were being released and not all the girls were released.
They paid money to the right people, to the judges. The job's not quite done, but it's almost done because now we need to go back and we need to rearrest every single one of these traffickers. It will be a message to Haiti, to America, to the whole world, that there are good people everywhere that will stand up for this.
Yeah, truly, truly heartbreaking. And I posted that link in the chat pane as well, and we'll post it in the description box for the YouTube channel. But the real goal for just this event, the big goal that we think would be amazing to hit for this particular fundraiser would be $25,000. I think that would be an absolute monumental accomplishment. So I'll keep you all posted on how we go, how we approach that. That'll be from not just one person, but from numerous people. And obviously if it could be from one person, amazing. But having that approach to knowing that we have an opportunity to have a direct impact into the lives of children, right? The lives of teenagers, the lives of kids from all around the world that we might not ever meet, but people that we really, really can have a direct and formidable impact with. So that leads me really, my dear friends, to just, if you have any questions at all, I will stop sharing the screen and just share the video for just a moment to see if anyone has any questions for me. Matt says, this is gonna be dinner tickets plus silent auctions. Yep, that's gonna be the total fundraiser goal. So dinner tickets, again, are proceeds that go directly to the foundation, silent auctions, all of those things. So if you are in the Miami area, or if you know someone that's in the Miami area, they can still come to this. They can still come to the fundraiser dinner. But I'd love to know if anyone has any questions for me. Leland says, the military briefs us on this every year. We get trained to watch for it. Man, that's so wild. I mean, really, it wasn't until extremely recently that I did not, I was unaware of this, just the scale and the magnitude. What was that number? $32 billion industry per year? Horrific. Absolutely terrible. Leland says, I've been seeing it for almost 20 years. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Sochi, are you coming on?
Yes, I just wanted to thank everybody. And also, one of the things that strikes my heart very much about Operation Underground Railroad is their organization, them risking their lives. And then also, they have an aftercare program that is already established. So when we donate, it's like we're donating to all aspects of this organization, and the aftercare is like, what do you do with these children and with these young teens? And they actually have so many a system in place in different countries. So this is a very well thought out program and a very well thought out organization. Been very impressed, and thank you, Jeremy. Thank you, describe everything extremely well. But I just wanted to share that, because what happens to these children afterwards? And they've got them covered.
Yeah, absolutely, Sochi. I really appreciate you bringing that up. In fact, guys, I'm sure you've probably pieced this together, but one of the things that real life trading can help with directly is pouring into these boys and girls, men and women, after the fact, as they go through this information, so that they can rehabilitate, but also start learning about finances. Because these are children and men and women and boys and girls that might not have any financial literacy at all. And you happen to be a part of an organization that would spend time, energy, resources, money, making sure that more and more people just simply learn how to use money, how to use currency, how to think about it, how to invest in it, how to save it. Just teaching them a skill that they can have for the rest of their lives. And that's something that I know we can accomplish together as a team. And it's so fun, it's so electrifying, and it's also depressing at the same time to know that this is such a huge scale. And there's that fear of, oh wow, why even do it? I'm not even going to make a dent. I'm not even going to make a single dent into this huge thing that's happening. But in all honesty, can we? And the answer is yes. $25,000 is the equivalent of saving 10 individual children. 10. So think about that, because that is a real number. I have met on numerous occasions at this point the men and women who actually go out and risk their lives as a civilian to rescue these men and women, one of them being one of my really close friends who is also in the currently in the military. And so having that knowledge and being able to hear some of the stories that it's almost graphic to even talk about how awful some of the treatment is, but to not get too sad or too terrifying on everyone, this is a cause, one of many that we can support, one of many that we now have an arm in real life trading that people can give to, that they can write off, that it's a nonprofit. All those things are gonna be, right, the whole 501c3 filings, all that aspect, something that can be a really beautiful force for good and a gorgeous, gorgeous directive location for people to donate to and to give to. So I'm very excited about that. Now, this is what I did not expect, but here we go. Let me go ahead and read some of these comments that are coming in the chat pane, because I'm sure that Sochi and Matt will be able to help figure out how we can do this. But I did not, again, when you're talking about something like this, some magnitude of how to help and how to give, and when you just open up your heart and your world, you start coming into things that you didn't think about. But Edward asked the question, are we able to donate items to put up for silent auctions? If so, is there a minimum value amount that you would accept? I don't think that there's gonna be a minimum value amount. I don't know the answer to that, but the answer I would assume would have to be yes. So she says, yes, please reach out to us to donate items for the auction. Nothing is too small. We appreciate everything. And then check this out. Leland says, I'd donate a prop from one of my drones that I flew in Iraq and Afghanistan. Yeah, wow. I mean, bro, I'll probably bid on that myself. That's so cool. Jonathan says, thank you for enlightening me. Have to go to Tony's mentorship group. Look forward to donating and helping. Yeah, dude, my absolute pleasure. Edward says, I'll donate one Tesla tequila bottle for the Lake Tahoe retreat dinner. Awesome, man. Awesome, awesome. So Edward's already pieced this together that there will be numerous of these, because yeah, that is sold out. The Tesla tequila bottle is a very, very randomly rare resource. So thanks, man. That's really awesome. Very, very kind of you. So guys, that's really it. This is going to be a very touching subject, because you know that March is Kids Month at Real Life Trading. And we do have two webinars coming up that are geared towards our young adults. We have the What Entrepreneurs Teach Their Kids, and then we have the Ask Me Anything Kids Edition. This is the link directly where you can donate. If you already know that this is something that you feel comfortable with, that you feel secure with, and that you want to give towards, we do already have a Venmo set up, the Real Life Foundation. It's spelled Real Life Foundation. This is the Venmo. All I have to do is scan this QR code with your camera and you'll be able to donate. The goal is $25,000 and we will keep you posted. Again, will this be the only cause that Real Life Trading donates to? No. Is this an extremely massively important cause that we can, Real Life Trading, make an impact and a direct help and assistance with? Absolutely. So my friends, I'm really, really thrilled to be a part of this journey with you. I'm just honestly blown away by the kindness and the love and the generosity of this community. I am every day, every single day, because the amount of people and clients and customers that reach out and want to buy a product or a class or a course or coaching for someone else is literally a daily occurrence. It's a daily occurrence that someone out there realizes the ease and the access that we have to capital and wants to provide it for other people who need it more. It's just amazing. So my friends from around the world, thank you. Matt, did you have anything that you wanted to say, my friend?
No, I think you nailed it. I think the big picture here, gang, is that Real Life Foundation is going to be used for a force for good. And this group that we're talking about, Operation Underground Railroad, they literally run like military style operations all over the world. And when I say all over the world, I mean South America, Indonesia, Thailand, even Canada and US. There's different laws, of course, in different countries. And so they work with local groups to make sure they capture enough footage or incriminating evidence to prosecute these people. So it's pretty interesting. It's a dark, dark thing that unfortunately has gone on for too long. And Jeremy, just what, 2 months ago, we were on an island in the British Virgin Islands, and we were talking about how we were going to change the world.
Yep.
And here we are.
Here we are, making our dent, making our waves. We never know the size or the waves or how they're going to impact other people, but we can at least make that ripple, my dear friend. So thank you all for being here, watching this, being a part of this. Guys, we created a foundation. That's so cool. Again, shout outs to Andres for pushing me to think that this is possible, and to Svetlana for helping me dream this, and of course to both Matt and Sochi for doing, I mean, hundreds of hours of work on this for the last few months. It's an honor and a privilege, guys, and we're able to just help so many and to think about all the greatness that we can do. So Marta says it was just a matter of time. That's right. And Marta, thank you, both you and your husband, and just how beautiful you guys are and how much you love each other. I want you to know that specifically, that me and Svetlana talk about how great both you guys are and how much love that you have. And it's just so, so cool to see that after so long. Just so much love and happiness and joy and merriment, you know. It's a beautiful thing. Beautiful thing. Tosh says, awesome work, RLT. Thank you, Tosh. Thank you. Thank you. Guys, we're going to hit it. $25,000. I promise it will absolutely happen between now. Is there an official quote unquote cutoff date, Matt?
I guess we can keep it open for like a few days after, but let's just say like maybe April. So the dinner is April 7th. So maybe we could just say like April 5th. By the end of the day, April 5th, so that Monday.
Yeah. Yep. Leland should be easy. Oh yeah. Well, it'll happen regardless. So
right. So at the dinner and the evening, at the end of the dinner, we'll announce who the winners are of the silent auction, but we can still collect donations, you know, a few days after. So
yeah. Love it, guys. Thank you so much for your time.